Theodore Billroth is an important person for surgeons. We should know some basics about him.
Theodore Billroth, who introduced the scholarship and training program in 1800s itself. Theodore Billroth had many special achievements. Most of his surgeries became the first to be done, such as laryngectomy, especially laryngectomy first done by Billroth. Even gastrectomy also first done by Billroth, which is developed in the middle of the 19th century, are still being performed with some of the modifications today. One of the keys to the longevity of his innovations, so he is an innovative person, was the establishment of world's formal surgical training program. So we have to train the juniors so that the skill goes on. In this program, the scholarship was including in the research. So scholarship, something which is to be supported to the students so that they can learn and then live also. So learning and earning don't go hand in hand, they say, but he made it possible by giving a scholarship. The drive to streamline the surgical training in many countries has tended to lead a simplified view of what a surgeon is. Surgeon is all hands-on, that is first described by Billroth. As surgical curriculum developed, it has been difficult to persuade politically driven mandarins to allow the reflection and research. So based on this only, most of the surgical training has developed. If we neglect these things, we will be signing up to view the surgeons as technicians only. So for treatment center and assembly line, surgeons are not so, they have to be trained hands-on. Training in research skills in the world of accelerating technological change can no longer be regarded as optional, however. Furthermore, scientists need people who can replace their new work in the context of real human cancers. For all the skills, oncologists do not have the same intimate relationship with the understanding of head and neck cancer and its functional sequel as head and neck surgeon. Therefore, we need to place future surgeons closer to the science and patient interface than previously been envisaged. Thank you.